What most people in America expect is a reasonable amount of safety when they lay their heads down for any type of nap, any type of sleep, any type of anything. But what we know about the Mexican community is that they do not regard our laws. A man in our community of Champaign, Illinois is constantly being sexualized by retail employees. They like to play the I've got you game. And the I've got you game is, oh, you need a little extra food today because you poor kid can't get a job today when there's so many job opportunities in our fucking retail restaurants and other type of grocery stores, and you just think you're above what we do for a living. What they don't get is what they don't get, that they chose their living. They chose their hourly wage, and they choose to live at home with mommy and daddy. Or they choose to live with a boyfriend or a girlfriend because that's what they chose. A man that uses his mind for Christ is different than a man who lies about his rights for Christ. A man who lies about his rights for Christ will cross a state line on behalf of his alleged wife. And I say alleged because she guaranteed was being abused by some police officer with some psychological program and literally got fucked out of her life with God. She absolutely doesn't know what her husband is doing in the middle of the night when he drives 2 hours to sexualize something. Or is it a big brother who just wants to teach a motherfucking lesson? Or is it some policeman who just doesn't care what happens to someone because he wants to win something? The reality of the world is that we have bitches on wheels who don't even have a God who would actually walk up to someone sleeping and cut their beard. Last night when I came to find a place to rest after an incredibly sweaty, hot day of doing my best to produce the words I need for my politician, who has to pick up those words at some point when she's done being a lazy-ass fucking vice president and actually do her job to protect America from the sinners, the bigamists, and all the other fucking liars of American presidency. We have to produce what God wants us to. When we produce what God wants us to, it's in our own life, motherfucker. It's not your right to sexualize someone, you little Chinese prick, and walk up to someone with your fucking scissors, you black bitch, and cut their beard off. You're not paying for that when you hand it in. What you just put yourself back to is slavery. And the rage in a man's voice should be heard by everyone. Because the minute you fucked across somebody's rights, the minute you fucking put your hands on someone in the night, the minute you did one fucking thing to not do your job, you fucking gay bitch, is when you lost your own rights. You see, only when you start to internalize that when you fucking piss on someone because of your fairy ass, faggot ass ideas in life, that you fucking forgot your own rights. The minute you get involved with something that says, I've got you, brother. No, you don't. You're not my fucking brother. My own brother's a fucking shitbag asshole who can't do one fucking thing right in his own fucking family. So don't you fucking say you're my brother. We sometimes say that to be polite to one another in the hood, but it doesn't really mean what it should. It means it for people who know to do their own fucking business and stay the fucking away from someone else's work. But the shitbags of a Staples community, the bitches of a Dollar Tree, the assholes of a PetSmart, and the motherfucking faggot-ass little girls of a fucking Party Tree can ruin somebody's life, you see. And the little gay boys of the Ultra Beauty Shop love to play I'm in charge of every person who looks like a faggot to me. But let me say something that's worse on wheels, that we have a police force that doesn't do their job. And the minute a reporter starts to say that, they start to look for a way in which they can harass the shit out of their life. So they pass around immorally lots of information, and all they prove is that they are a part of Satan who killed Jesus Christ.